Related to communion meditation, I ask you to listen to the words as it expresses their love for each other and for other couples living here today as well.
Blessing upon Daphne and Alice.
Father, creator of the universe, maker of us in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this couple, who today is united in the sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon both of them, so that they may love, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you are there to help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach an old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. First of all, I'm Father Anthony. I see that we have a lot of people who haven't been here before, and certainly you are welcome to be here. Some of you may be thinking to yourself, well, what is this church all about? So first I'd like to extend my congratulations to Alice and Anthony on this significant occasion. Weddings and marriage obviously are not just private affairs, but they affect society. And in our society, we're having many discussions about what that means. And I think that affects what this church means, too. I believe, and this church believes, that first of all, let me point out that we're part of the National Catholic Church of North America, not part of the Roman Catholic Church. But we have our Catholic in tradition and in belief in pretty much all things. And we believe that when God created us, He created us for good, and that we should make our lives better. And one of the most important things in all of our lives is that we are able to grow and we are able to be ourselves. And right from the very beginning, there were all kinds of people who were telling us who we are, what we should be, and how we should act. And sometimes we don't feel that that's the right way, that doesn't fit in with who I am. One of the most significant influences in all of our lives is our religion and our religious beliefs. So we have a very positive religious belief. We believe that people should be able to achieve their potential, and they should be able to learn to love, and they should be able to learn to grow. And that's why this is such a significant occasion, not just for each of you and your private families, but it's a significant occasion for us here in this church, because other churches do not believe the same way. I was a bit distressed this past week by the United Methodist Church decision to not recognize commitment and the marriage of gay people. New gay people are forbidding their clergy to participate in an occasion such as this, which I think is a beautiful one, and I'm sure you join with me in expressing that sentiment as well. So I think it's really important for us to take a moment to realize how wonderful and how significant this occasion is for them and for us, and that we step forward to become a better person. And a lot of people telling us, oh no, this isn't the way it should be. People shouldn't be doing this. This is not really a sacrament. If you went down the street, probably would tell you that. But we certainly affirmed it, and you saw the beauty of this today. This is what God really wants, and that's what this church is. We are perhaps an alternative to that. But I hope that you will continue to join with us in that spirit of love that we heard about in the second reading today that makes all of our lives better. So, again, my congratulations, and also the fact that to recognize that we are part of something that's historical, and we are something that is truly a significant part of our age, as Father Jim mentioned in the first part of this talk.
Any other announcements? Let's continue on. Let us pray. eat what I've shared, the food of your table. Pray for our friends, Daphne and Alex, whom you have joined together in marriage. Keep them close to you always. May their love for each other proclaim to all the world of their faith in you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May God the Almighty Father give you his joy. Amen.
Amen.
May the only Son of God have mercy on you and help you in the good and in the bad.
Amen.
May the Holy Spirit of God always fill your hearts with his love.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless all of you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration of love is ending here, but it continues out there. Go and do what Christ asks by taking Christ to the world.
Thanks be to God.
Our closing hymn, go on me this side, the right-hand side book, it'll be number 381.
Thank you.